Dear doctors, I'm Dr. Mizuno, Vice Principal and Director of GI Unit of Classic Center Hospital. I'm pleased to introduce you Dr. Yuichi Shimodate here. He has recently published a paper in gastrointestinal endoscopy entitled Impact of Submucosal Saline Injection for Cold Snare Polypectomy of Small Colorectal Polyps, a randomized controlled study. He is going to summarize his work in this interview. Dr. Shimodate, please start telling us brief backgrounds of your work.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Yuichi Shimodate from the Department of Gastroenterology and Hepatology of Kurashiki Central Hospital in Japan. Thank you so much for inviting me to the author interview of gastrointestinal endoscopy. As you know, recently, cold snare polypectomy, CSP, is a widely accepted procedure for small colorectal polyps. And the European Society of Gastrointestinal Endoscopy recommends CSP for removal of small colorectal polyps. However, this technique is still troubled with insufficient resection depth, which may prevent precise pathological evaluation. Actually, we have reported cases of CSP resected polyps with advanced histology and unclear vertical margins. In such cases, we were really worried about additional therapy. So we needed to improve the quality of resected specimens for appropriate histological evaluation.
So, what was your plan?
In a randomized control study from Europe, the rate of histological complete resection was over 19% in the cold snare EMR for non-pedunculated small colorectal polyps. This was not inferior to that with hot snare EMR. Thus, we hypothesized that the submucosal injection of normal saline would improve the rate of complete resection of tumor tissues in CSP. So we investigated whether submucosal injection of saline helps to achieve deeper resection in CSP.
How did you do it?
We compared the complete resection rates of CSP with submucosal saline injection with that of conventional CSP as a single-center prospective randomized open-label trial at Kurashiki Central Hospital. The complete resection, as you can see in the slide, was defined if muscularis mucosa in the resected specimen was present under the tumor along more than 80% of tumor's horizontal dimension and was a primary endpoint. Non-pedunculated colorectal polyp 3 to 10 mm in diameter and with endoscopic diagnosis of adenoma or sessile serrated region was studied. In total, 214 patients were enrolled and randomly assigned to CSP either with submucosal injection in the CSPSI group or conventional CSP in the CCSP group.
Then, what happened?
The rate of complete muscularis mucosa resection was 43.9% in the CSPSI group and 53.3% in the CCSP group, which was statistically insignificant, indicating the submucosal injection did not improve the quality of resected specimens of CSP in terms of resection depth. We evaluated other outcomes as secondary endpoints. Among them, the rates of negative lateral and vertical margin in the CSPSI group were significantly lower than those in the CCSP group. This was really unexpected. For safety, there was no polypectomy-related major bleeding or perforation.
Okay, how do you feel about your results?
We had really expected that submucosal injection would improve the quality of CSP resected specimens for pathological evaluation, but it did not. We have no convincing explanation for the negative impact of submucosal injection in CSP. Elevation of lesions by the injection allows the snare to more easily grasp lesions, but the CSP snare without electrode cautery could have slipped over the elevated stiff muscularis mucosa layer. The finding that the rates of histologically negative lateral and vertical margins were lower in the CSPSI group than in the CCSP group was unexpected and is concerning. The reason for this is not clear to us, but it is further reason to be skeptical of the adequacy of CSP with submucosal injection. Recently, the efficacy of underwater CSP for resection of small colorectal adenomas has been reported. In that method, significantly higher rates of outer resection and proportion of area containing muscular mucosa was achieved compared with that of conventional CSP. Strategies other than submucosal injection, such as underwater CSP, may be needed to improve the quality of CSP resection.
Thank you very much, Dr. Shimodate. So, would you please conclude your presentation?
Yes, in this prospective randomized control study, I'd like to conclude that injection of epinephrine normal saline into the submucosa did not increase the depth of resection of small colorectal polyps removed with CSP. Moreover, doubt about the thoroughness of polyp resection was further arise based on the finding of lower rates of negativity of lateral and vertical polyp margins with submucosaline injection than without injection. Considering these findings, in addition to the expense and time that saline injection imposes, the technique cannot be recommended for removal of small colorectal polyps with CSP. Better methods are needed to achieve sufficiently deep resection in CSP, and improvement of polypectomy snare may also be necessary for enabling the easy grasp of regions together with some submucosal layer. Thank you for watching.